It's Nathan Birch here from B.Invested.com.au, group of companies. And for you that don't know me, you might be thinking, why should I be watching this YouTube video? What's this guy all about? And what's he going to tell me today? I don't go on TV for no reason and talk about property portfolios. I don't get voted as Investor of the Year for no reason. I've developed a system 10 years ago exactly. I left school, I failed school, so when I write on the whiteboard today, it's the first time I've drawn on a whiteboard beforehand, my writing is pretty crap, so just let me tell you that. What I want to share with you today is just a simple equation. People always email through to me and ask me questions about, Nathan, how do I build a property portfolio of 10 plus properties in a quick short time frame? Just a little bit more about me. 72, 73 properties, I think I'm up to about 74 properties now in less than 10 years. Passive income stream over $200,000 per year. I'm going to show you the tips and strategies on how I develop my property portfolio to give me financial independence so I don't have to turn up to work on Monday morning and have to live life on someone else's terms. I get to do things that I want on my terms, and that's a lot about why I buy property. On this, a lot of people say, Nathan, I've got, let's use the example of $50,000. I want to buy 10 properties, 20 properties. It just all comes down to your situation on how much equity that you've personally got, what your current liabilities are as far as expenses, children, spouse working or not, a lot of different reasons. But let's say that you're a single person, you're on $60,000, $70,000 per year, and you've got $50,000 saved that's in the bank. With it, how can you build a property portfolio and how can it be successful? Let's have a look at it on the board here. Let's say that you buy property number one for $200,000. $200,000 is a nice number that I like to work with, and the reason why I like to work with that is because it's a bread and butter sort of price range. It's a low entry price into a capital city market. Remembering, if you want to go and buy a regional property, these numbers will still work. If you go and buy a property that's $100,000, you'd need half the amount of capital. If you want to go and buy a property that's more than that, if you have more money saved, if you have less money saved, you can work around the numbers. But this is just a simple equation on how it can happen. Let's say, for instance, you go and buy a property for $200,000. It could be a property in Sydney, it could be a property in Brisbane, it could be a property wherever. Let's assume that that property is a below market value property and it's worth $250,000. Remembering, it's very important that you buy a property below market value. Tip number one. The reason why is that you've got a $50,000 buffer here in case you have to sell the property, in case the market falls or whatever, you've got an exit strategy. It also gives you the opportunity to have equity built that you can unlock and go and move on to your next property and subsequent properties after that. So buying the property below market value, $200,000 purchase price, it's got a value of, clear that up a little bit for you, it's got a value of $250,000. This property will rent for say $300 per week or $320 per week. Let's say $300 per week. And let's say it's got a cash flow position of $0. It's not costing you anything, it's not putting money in your pocket, it's just a neutral cash flow property. With this here, you've got your $200,000. You go to the bank and get yourself a loan on it of an 80% lend. So the bank will lend you $160,000. As I said, my writing's crap, so don't hold me to that, but I know how to invest. You would need to put in $40,000 deposit. With that $40,000 deposit, let's say $10,000 closing cost, stamp duty, legal fees, maybe paint or carpet or something in the property. You've bought a property, you've got property number one locked away. It's all done. How do you move on to property number two? You go back to the bank, you say to the bank, I want to order a valuation. It's important to have a right finance strategy here to be able to go back to the bank, then to understand your goals, and for you to be able to tap back into that equity. With the banks, they're all different. I like dealing with the big four banks. It's personal choice on who you want to deal with. I've found the best results being with the big four banks because they will revalue the property in a shorter time frame than 12 months. Let's say you go back to the bank in 3 months' time, and I don't have anything here to wipe this off, so I'm going to just draw some more properties here. You go to the bank, you've got your $250,000, you ask them to revalue the property at $250,000. Got enough zeros there. Revalue the property at $250,000. You get an 80% lend of that. Always like using 80% LVR. 80% LVR, it keeps you out of mortgage insurance, lender's mortgage insurance. It saves you money, but it also means that you've got a lower risk. It's important to minimize your risk when you're building your portfolio, and always be mindful of risk minimization. If you go back to the bank, value the property at $250,000, they come back and say, yep, the property's worth that because properties in the street and other properties currently for sale have sold and on the market for $250,000, a comparable thing, we'll lend you $250,000 as a new value. You get an 80% lend of that, so you get your $200,000 back. That means you've got your $200,000 in your loan limit, minus your $160,000 initial loan, gives you $40,000 back. These are very rough numbers here, guys, so don't hold me to this. It could be up to $280,000, it could be a purchase price for $180,000, it could be a purchase price for $100,000, as long as the numbers stack up. Remember, it's holding no bearing on your lifestyle choices. It's not costing any money out of your pocket, it's not putting any money into your pocket. You pull out this equity, you go buy a second property. So you've got property number one, let's take it out from here, let's say it's here, you buy a second property. My properties do look better than that. You repeat the process. The thing to remind you, the faster you can go when building a property portfolio is limited to how fast you can actually structure yourself. You structure yourself right. I've seen people buy 10 properties in 3 months, 4 months. I've seen people buy 15 properties, 20 properties in 12 months, 2 years. So it is possible, and these people aren't people that have got millions of dollars, they're not on high incomes, there's just everyday mums and dads that are doing this. And if you've got more money, then you've got more potential to buy more stuff. Let's say, for instance, you just buy 3 or 4 properties in a year. After year one, you've got 4 properties. Year two, repeat the same process. If you can save up money in the meanwhile, you've got 2 lots of capital working, you can buy 2 lots of properties. If you've got a bigger starting capital than $50,000, wherever the $50,000 was, you've got potential to buy more properties. If you don't have as much money, you can buy a cheaper property, just as long as you get the action happening, and buying properties that are below market value so you can build a property portfolio. Year one, if you keep going on, build a property portfolio, and buy 10 properties, we'll have a look at how this will work for you and review now how 10 properties can build you a passive income stream.